this is the place that makes me optimistic. That's why I like to come here.
So coming here to the Clean Energy Policy and EXPO Forum has been very beneficial to our organization. It allows us to interact face-to-face with a lot of influencers in the broader clean energy ecosystem.
I think that we're one of the only energy institutes, though, that are exhibiting today. So I think that that's been unique. We've had a lot of Congress staff come to us looking at what's the latest research you guys are working on and really looking to us for policy recommendations.
And when you talk to a member of Congress, the one thing they always want to know is, how does that affect my district? And the answer, you've got an answer. Well, it makes your air cleaner. It makes your jobs stronger. And it saves people money. That's not a bad message.
Yeah, so our work is to facilitate dialogue, and we hope that by being nonpartisan and getting people on both sides of the aisle, that this will kind of help a lot of the energy gridlock that's going on with legislation in Congress.
Republicans, this is about Democrats, this is about our planet and how to move our economy and our country forward. And that's why I did this as a Republican, working forward in the state of Nevada.
None of us are escaping the impact of carbon pollution and greenhouse gases. Many of us want to add jobs to the economy, and significant paying jobs at that. And none of us wants to destroy the well-being, and the health and well-being of our constituents.
And you know, maybe the biggest lie of all is that you have to choose between jobs and clean energy or the environment. That is a false choice.
Energy efficiency is a national security priority. This goes to the basic level of protecting our force in the field. Why should we be dragging, towing, trucking tons of gasoline to our troops when we can support them with alternative energy? It's